Hi, my name is Ben Hodes, Senior Program Manager for Project Siena, and for this how-to video, we're going to walk through building out the Health Cost Calculator app. Let's take a look. So this app is about medical events and what they really cost if you have insurance or you're only partially covered. It's a good way to have a conversation about making sure that we're covered for all possible medical events. So let's go ahead and take a look at asthma.
I'm Alexis from Fort Wayne, Indiana. About 6 months ago, I started coughing a lot, had shortness of breath, I was getting tired easily. Then one day, I broke out in hives and couldn't breathe at all. My roommate called an ambulance.
Now, as Alexa describes, the medical care that she had to go through,
chest x-rays, I was diagnosed with chronic asthma.
The real cost.
The doctors prescribed me an inhaler
than the total
and medications.
Cost of all of the events.
My insurance ended up covering it all.
And as I move the slider,
I don't know what I would have done without it.
Live. Great. So let's see how to build it. As we go through this, there may be parts that you want additional clarification on or need a little more help with. We actually have a whole bunch of more content, just like this video, available on our website at aka.ms/projectsiena. Specifically, I'd recommend that you check out the sample app section for another video where we walk through building an app from end to end. To get started, we'll go to the desktop, and I already have the health cost calculator assets expanded here. So as you may recall from our other how-to videos, the first thing we need to do is copy over our Siena assets folder into the public pictures directory. Taken care of, now all of our assets are in the right place. We have our data file here pointing to those assets, and we have the actual Siena document if we wanted to open that up. But we're just going to build from scratch. Let's get building. So if I remember from our app, we have two screens. The first screen is where I can see all the videos of medical events and select a video to watch. And the second screen is where I can actually watch it and see the corresponding medical events pop up in time. So I'll just go ahead and add two screens. I'll name my first screen the selection screen. We'll name the second screen the video screen. And we'll select the first screen. Next, let's get some data into our app. I swipe from the top or right click to get the top app bar. I go to File, Data Sources. We're going to use Excel. And I'm going to select the Excel sheet that came with the rest of the assets. For me, it's just on the desktop. You can find it on your hard drive. Select and click Open. Select the tables we want to import and click Import Data. Looks like everything came in all right. We see the video URL. Our images are showing up, which means we copied our assets over to the public pictures directory properly. And our diseases table was properly imported. This contains information about medical events, and the showtime column tells us when those medical events are mentioned in the videos. First, let's go ahead and get our title for the app in there. Now, this isn't going to look exactly the same as our sample app, but we'll make it look pretty close. Go down to design. We can style this a little bit. Give it a nice blue. Okay. Next, let's add the gallery to view our videos. I just went to add, selected a gallery, and I'm going to choose an image gallery with caption for this one. Just resized it to fit my screen here. I'm going to go to items, and I want this gallery to pick up the videos table. Pretty good. I see some of the images are getting clipped here, so I'm going to select the image, go to design, image position, and select fit. It's looking pretty good so far. On this screen, the only thing that remains is that when I click the image, or when I select one of these videos, it should navigate to the second screen and start playing the video. So let's get set up that navigate. Select the video, go to on select, navigate, and I want to navigate to my video screen. working as expected. On this screen, let's first add a shape, which is a back button. I need to be able to get back to the previous screen after all. Just resized it. I'll go to unselect, navigate, and navigate to our selection screen. Now when I click that button, we'll go back, select an item, move forward. Of course, on this screen, we need to have a video player so that we can actually see the video. Let's add that. Whoops, went down too far. There's a video player right there. I'm going to make it the full screen, and then I'm going to arrange, order, send it back so that, our button is on the top. Now we want this video to point at the URL that we had selected on the previous screen. So I'm going to go to Media. Gallery 1, bang selected. That's actually the gallery from the first one, the selected item. And from there, we want to see the video URL.
I'm Alexis from...
Great. We don't need the default image anymore, so I'm going to go ahead and erase that. And now we have an app where I can select and watch the video.
My name is Mindy.
This is great, but now we need the information on the side that shows us the cost of medical events as well as our total cost. So let's go ahead and get some of those rectangles in. First we'll go to Shapes, and I'll add a rectangle. This is going to be our total cost rectangle. Remove the border. Go to Border Thickness and make that 0. Next I'm going to add my labels. So I added one label, and this is going to say total cost. And I'll add one more label that will contain the total cost. Right now it just says label, but we'll do something like this. Let's style it up a little. Make it white. Stands out better. Great. And we'll hook this up in a minute, because what we need to do right now is add a gallery, a vertical gallery here, that shows all the medical events as they're mentioned in the video. Go to Galleries, and what we're going to want to do is add a vertical custom gallery. Now let's define how our custom gallery should look by adding some controls to the gallery template. First, I don't think that I'm going to need my gallery items to be so tall, so I'm going to go to Template Size. We're going to bump that down. About 100 makes sense. Maybe 125. Next, I'm going to add 3 labels and a slider. This first label is going to be the actual medical event. This next label is going to be what the price would be without coverage. Our next label is going to actually show us how much covered, how covered we are, and the slider will help us pick our coverage. Now I notice that this is starting to get a little tight, so I'm going to go ahead and give it a little bit more space horizontally. Likewise, give it a little more space horizontally at the top. And let's place everything nice. Do a little formatting. And great. Now this, of course, doesn't mean anything. We see lots of nonsense here. It's our sample text. So let's select the gallery, go to Data, Items, and let's have this pick up from the diseases table. All right, pretty close. Siena made some guesses at what we want the labels to show. So let's go ahead and update those. I actually want this to say asthma. So I'll go to Text and select Disease. I want this text box to show the cost, so I'll go to Text and select Cost. And I want to do a little formatting here, so I can actually say, using the Excel text function, let's format this a little bit more like a price. Get rid of the decimals, we don't need those. And then this label is going to show us what the percentage covered we are. So let's use our Excel knowledge to write an expression that takes care of that. I'm going to go to text, and we're going to erase this and say we want to show the slider, the value. Onto that, we'll go ahead and concatenate a percentage and say covered. Now, test this out. As we move the slider, we see that that percentage is updated. Of course, since I can see the percentage there, I don't need the tooltip. So I'm going to turn off the tooltip by going to Design, More, or excuse me, not under More, under Show Value, turn that off. Of course, right now I'm seeing all medical events, irrespective of the disease or the video or anything like that. And if, what we wanted to do is we wanted to have this filter and only show us events as she mentions them in her video. Let's write a filter that takes care of that. So I selected the gallery, I go to Data, go to Items, and instead of just binding to the diseases table, we're going to say we want to filter diseases such that the disease is equal to gallery 1, selected item, disease. Of course, we also only want to see events as they're mentioned in the video. So also filter on show time is less than or equal to the video player time. Finally, we want the most recent items to show up at the bottom, so we're going to add a sort on showtime ascending. At this point, let's test it out and see if our expression works.
And I'm an interior designer from Seattle, Washington. I was 31 years old when I went to see my doctor for a routine checkup. During the physical exam, he found a mass in my breast. He said it was probably nothing, just a cyst, but maybe we should get it checked out just in case. After a biopsy, mammogram, and MRI,
at this point, I let it play, and I noticed that the behavior of the gallery wasn't exactly what I wanted. What I'm looking for is instead of it saying what the disease is, I want it to say the medical event. So it's very easy to fix. I'll just select that label, go to text, and instead of disease, select treatment. Great. Well, I think this is looking pretty good. The only thing remaining is to have the total cost update with as I move the sliders. Let's write our final Excel expression to make that happen. So I'm going to select our total cost, label here, go to text, and instead of hard coding this, let's make it dynamic based on the gallery. So I'm going to say that I want to sum my gallery 3. I'm going to hold down Alt to see all the controls, and I notice that the gallery that I added on the right is called gallery 3. Gallery 3 bang all items. So I'm going to sum over all of the items in Gallery 3. I would like to sum the cost. And what we're going to say is subtract the slider value times 0.01, because it's a percent, times the cost. Now, when we have 100%, our cost will be 0. When we have 0%, our cost will be the full cost of the event. Close that off, add my text formatting function to make it look like a nice price. And now let's test it out quickly. As I move the sliders, we'll see prices adjust accordingly. And let's bump these over so we have a nice formatting. Finally, we want our video to automatically start playing when we select it. We've done this pattern in previous videos, but just as a recap, the way that we do this is with a context variable. On the first screen, we set a context variable that's passed to the second screen that tells our video to play, and on the second screen, we update that context variable to false so the video stops playing before navigating back to the first screen. Let's see that in action. To pass a context variable, I'm going to select the image that's navigating to my second screen. I go to the onSelect behavior, and I update my navigate to include a context. says video paused should be false because we want the video to play. I'll select it to set that variable. On the back button, of course, we need to do the opposite and say that before we navigate, to update the context so our video paused is true. And our final step being to actually tell the video to respect, to pick up the context variable. And we do that by going to default paused and saying video paused.
I'm Alexis from Fort Wayne, Indiana.
Let's see if it works. I'm going to right click, go to preview. Let's check out our app.
My name is John. I'm from Boise, Idaho. A few years back, I was diagnosed with type 2 diabetes and had to start taking insulin. One day, I'd say about 3 months ago, I was feeling dizzy and faint, didn't think much of it. But my wife insisted on rushing me to the ER. We came to find out my coronary arteries were blocked and I needed immediate heart bypass surgery.
I'm gonna call this a finished app. I'm gonna go ahead and hit Control S to save. Finally, we're going to publish the app. To do that, I'm going to right-click, swipe from the top, go to File, give it a nice display name, Health Calculator, and I'm going to select Publish Resources Locally because all of my assets are on this machine, and if I don't do this, then when my app publishes, they won't be included, and I'll have a bunch of missing pictures and videos in my app. Select Publish Resources Locally, hit Publish. My desktop is a good place to do it. Click Choose this folder and OK. Siena has gathered everything together and put it on a Publish Package folder on my desktop. Let's go ahead and view that. Let's drop to the desktop. And there's my Publish Package folder. Open it up. I'm going to go ahead and run Install App. I can install on this PC or create an AppX for sharing. I just want to install it on my PC. And we're done. In Windows 8.1, the app won't be automatically pinned to the start screen, so we have to search for it. To do that, just type Health Calculator. There's our app. And great. Everything looks to be in working
order. I'm Robert from Kansas City, Missouri. Around, I'd say, my wife was by my side in an ambulance. Once in the ER, the doctor told me I had kidney failure and they needed.
And that's how to build the Contoso Health Calculator app. We hope you enjoyed this. For more tips, tricks, and videos, go ahead and visit us online at aka.ms/projectsiena. Thank you very much.